On October 13, 2015, Airbus and Singapore Airlines launched the ULR, or ultra-long range, variant of the Airbus A350-900. This variant was delivered 3 years later and has been flying with the one airline ever since. Indeed, Singapore Airlines operates all 7 A350-900 ULRs that were produced, and these jets are most often deployed on just one route. And so for today's video, we'll look at what specifically makes the A350-900 ULR different from its more regular counterparts. On September 22, 2018, Airbus delivered the first A350-900 ULR aircraft to launch customer Singapore Airlines. At the time, Airbus highlighted that this variant of the A350-XWB was capable of flying further in commercial service than any other aircraft, with a range of up to 9,700 nautical miles or 18,000 kilometers. Under ideal conditions, this equates to over 20 hours of continuous flight. Singapore Airlines put the jet into service a few weeks later with non-stop services between Singapore and New York. With an average flying time of 18 hours and 45 minutes, this has been and continues to be the world's longest commercial flight. The statement offered by the airline's CEO upon taking first delivery is as follows. "This is a proud moment for both Singapore Airlines and Airbus, not only because we have again strengthened our partnership, but also because we have pushed the limits with this highly advanced new aircraft to extend long-range flying to new lengths." It was added that the A350-900 ULR would bring more convenience and comfort to customers while also boosting the carrier's network competitiveness. But technically speaking, how does the ULR differ from non-ULR A350s? For this, we turn to Airbus's Aircraft Characteristics Airport and Maintenance Planning publication. Well, as you can see on the chart here, Airbus has actually developed numerous A350-900 variants, continuously modifying and improving capabilities over the years. While to the public, most will simply be known as the A350-900, each model has a more specific code. These start at WV000 and currently go right through to WV023. We're guessing more changes and more variants will come in the future, but again, it's just a guess. But going back to the ULR specifically, this variant has been assigned the code WV013. And so, comparing the WV013 with other Dash 900s, we can see that it has a 280 metric ton maximum takeoff weight, where many others have lower MTOWs. It does appear, however, that the most recent A350-900 iterations, WV022 and 023, have similar weight tolerances as the ULR. This is unsurprising, as we know that many of the technologies developed with the ULR were integrated into regular production A350-900s. Indeed, even in 2018, Airbus noted that the ULR featured a number of aerodynamic enhancements, including extended winglets, which are, quote, "now being applied to all in-production A350-900 aircraft." Continuing through Airbus's documentation, the A350-900 ULR is designed to carry fewer passengers. The jet was actually envisioned to only carry around 173 passengers as its standard configuration, 80 in business class and 93 in economy class. In the real world, with Singapore Airlines, it's 161 passengers, 67 in business class and 94 in premium economy class. This is in stark contrast to the 315 passengers stated to be the standard seating capacity for other A350-900s, with 48 in business and 267 in economy class. When it comes to usable fuel, we can see that the ULR carries up to 165,000 litres, or 43,589 US gallons. This is a fair bit more than the 138,000 litres, or 36,456 US gallons, that standard Dash 900s carry. On the topic of fuel capacity, Airbus highlights that the main change over the standard aircraft is a modified fuel system, enabling increased capacity. The interesting part is that the change has been made without the need for additional fuel tanks. Aside from this, it looks like cockpit volume and passenger compartment volumes are identical. If we move further down this Airbus document, we can see that the A350-900ULR's forward cargo hold is actually deactivated and no cargo operation is possible in this section of the aircraft. As a result, the A350-900ULR loses the ability to carry about 89.5 cubic meters of cargo. And it's not just less cargo and fewer passengers. It also appears that the aircraft carries fewer potable water and wastewater tanks. Where a standard A350 will see 1,060 liters of potable water, or 280 US gallons, the ULR would take just 750 liters, or 198 US gallons. Airbus's documentation also notes that expected turnaround times are different from standard -900s. According to the plane maker, turnaround time for a standard -900 is 61 minutes, with the most time-consuming activities being deplaning and boarding, as well as cargo unloading and loading. For the larger A350-1000, turnaround time is expected to be around 70 minutes. But then, for the -900ULR, Airbus gives an estimated turnaround time of 83 minutes. In the case of this variant, refueling is the main factor keeping the aircraft on the ground. As noted earlier, Singapore Airlines ordered 7 ULRs, and in terms of aircraft registrations, these go from 9 Victor Sierra Golf Alpha, alphabetically through to 9 Victor Sierra Golf Golf. Looking at recent flight data, the jets of course mainly operate between Singapore Changi and New York City. Indeed, the jets serve both major New York area airports, JFK and Newark Liberty. The airline began with Newark but switched to Kennedy during the pandemic. These days, however, customers have the option of flying Singapore to either airport. At the same time, customers of Singapore Airlines may find the aircraft flying elsewhere. Indeed, at the time of this video's production, checking Flight Radar 24 shows that the jets have occasionally flown from Singapore to Los Angeles. It also looks like one of the jets was deployed to Kuala Lumpur as well. At the end of the day, when you realize that the ULR's game-changing range can be heavily attributed to fewer passengers, an empty forward cargo compartment, and 250 liters less potable water, the ultra-long-range capability is perhaps less impressive. Surely an older, standard A350 with its unmodified fuel system would be able to fly significantly further than its published range under such circumstances. Interestingly, while the A350-900ULR was marketed with its own special name, the jet can be turned into a standard variant by reactivating its forward cargo compartment. As noted by Flight Global, from an airframe perspective, it is simply an issue of paperwork. So, despite the cool name and the special letters at the end, the A350-900ULR's capabilities are more or less comparable to new -900s coming from Airbus these days. Nonetheless, all of these changes have allowed Singapore Airlines to resume the world's longest flight, which it previously operated with the Airbus A340-500. The airline launched Singapore-New York service with this Airbus quad jet in 2004, but called it off in 2013. What are your thoughts about the A350-900ULR? Did you know about all of these differences as compared to the standard -900? Let us know what you think in the comments section. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.